Hello everyone, welcome you all. In this video, I'm going to show you how to handle frames in Protractor. So first of all, let us understand what is frame or iframe. So sometimes when you see your websites, you can find the different sections. So those sections basically called as a frames. Now let me show you one example. Here the entire web page is divided into multiple parts. So we can call them as a frames. So here I have opened one URL and here you can see this. This is a complete one web page and which contains a multiple sections. So this is the first section, this is one frame. And here the second section, which is also another frame, and this is a third frame. So totally we have a three frames in this particular page. So when you want to perform any operations within this frame, or if you want to click on some element, or if you want to validate something on this in this frame, so we need to navigate through these frames. Until unless we navigate it, or until unless we switch to this frame, we cannot perform the operations on elements. So here we'll see how we can switch to one frame to another frame to perform the action on those elements. So for example, here on the first frame, I want to just click on something called org.openqr.selenium. So once you click on this link, the corresponding data will be displayed in the second frame. Again, here I want to click on something called Webdriver, then it will open another page. So this is another frame. So how we can do this operation? So we cannot directly perform these operations because these elements are present inside the frame. So if these elements are present inside the frame, we need to switch to the frame and then we can perform the action. So basically these frames are present inside the web page. Now we'll see how we can handle them. So first of all, let's go to Visual Studio Code and here I'm creating new test case, and under test cases, I'll name it as frames.js. Now here, first of all, I'll create one describe block. So let me just say describe, and in the describe block, I'll say name of the test suite. I'll say test suite and comma, the function in which we need to write multiple it blocks. And here I'll write one it block, and the name of the it block is, let's say, frames test. And here also the test we need to implement in the function. Right, so now inside this it block, we need to start writing your test. So basically this is application which is non-Angular based application, non-Angular JS application. So if you want to interact with the elements on non-Angular JS applications, we need to set one property here. That is browser dot wait for Angular enable false. So this one we have seen in the previous video, how we can handle non-Angular JS application. So first we need to set this property false, and then we can interact with the non-Angular JS applications. And after setting this property, I'll say browser.get, and here I need to specify the URL of application. So copy this URL and specify inside double quotation or single quotation. So this will open up my application on the browser. Then after that, I want to maximize this browser. For that, I can say browser dot, and we have a command called browser.manage.window.maximize. So this will maximize your browser window. So basically this command is coming from Webdriver, Selenium Webdriver. So after maximizing this window, now we need to interact with the elements which are present inside the frame. So normally how we can interact with this. So for example, I have org.openqr.selenium. So I want to click on this link. So before clicking on this link, we need to switch to this particular frame and then we can perform the action. Similarly, before performing any action, the second frame, we need to switch to the second frame. Then we need to perform the action. Then before switching to the frame, we need to know some of the attributes of the frames. And before that, also we need to know whether we have frames on the web page or not, right? So for that, what you can do is, if it is a Chrome browser, you can just right click on the whole web page and click on the inspect. Now here you can see some of the new tags called frame tags. If I just see here, this is my frame set. Inside this, there is one frame. As soon as I highlighted this line, you can see here on my browser, this particular frame is highlighting. This is the first frame. And if you see the first frame, there are some properties are available, attributes are available. SRC is one attribute, name is attribute, title is another attribute. If the name is directly available, we can use this name attribute to locate the frame. Or sometimes if we find any ID or all, then we need to use find element. Then we have to use element, browser.element method by locating the element in the protractor. So similarly, you have another frame here, and the name of the frame is package frame. And this is a third frame, the name of the frame is class frame. So we need to get these names from those frames. And we can use this names attribute to locate the frames. And then we can switch to the frame. So once you're successfully located, and we need to switch to the frame. So for that, what I can do is, as soon as I maximize the browser, so first you need to go to the first frame. So we need to switch to the first frame. So for that, I'll say browser dot, there is a method called switch to dot frame. So even this command is also come from Selenium Webdriver. So browser dot switch to dot frame. And here, if you already have the name directly, you can directly specify the name like this. Suppose if we just go to the first frame, so this is the name of the first frame, capture this and specify here. So this command will switch to the first frame. And suppose if the name is not available, here we need to pass the element. So before this writing the statement, we need to locate the element, frame element, by using ID or any other attributes. Then we can pass that element as an argument here. So browser dot switch dot frame. So if you have free of the name or ID directly available, we can pass the name or ID directly here. So this command will switch to first frame, or we can simply say first frame. So once you switch to the first frame, then we need to perform the action. So here I'm going to click on the first link called org opencure.selenium. So let's inspect that element. And if you already have a Chrome path installed on your Chrome browser, which will give you all the link text and CSS locator, XPath, all these things, you can use these as a locators. So I'm just capturing the link text of the first element, which is present inside the first frame. Now I'm going to click on that link. So how to locate the link and how we can perform the click action. So for that, we have to use element method, element of, and this is a lowercase letter. So element of, and here I'm going to use link text. So we can access by dot, I'll say link text. So this is the method. So by dot link text, and whatever link text we capture, specify that and then apply click action. So this will go and click on the first link on the first frame. So these two are interrelated. So we have switched to the first frame, then we perform the action on the inside the first frame. We have just click on the link. So after doing this, we need to do one more thing. So we cannot directly go and click on the another link in the second frame. So we cannot directly switch to one frame to another frame. So here what we have to do is basically, if you try to understand this, this is my frame, this is my browser page. And inside this, we have a multiple frame. So this is my frame one, let's say F1, and this is my F2, this is another frame. And now here I have another frame, let's say F3 frame. So now here I need to click on this element, click on the link. Then this frame two, I need to click on one more link, and frame three also I need to click on one more link. So three different elements are present in three different frames. So now this is my browser. So first we have switched to the internal browser, first to frame, and then we have performed the action. After doing this action, we need to go back to the main page again. Then we need to go to the second frame and then do the action. Again, we need to go back to the main page. Again, we have to go to the third frame. So this is how we need to switch between multiple frames. But we cannot directly switch to one frame to another frame. So this is not possible. So first we need to go to the default page, and then we need to switch the second frame, again go back to the main page, then switch to the third frame. So how we can go back to the main page? So here this command will switch to the it will switch to the first frame and perform the action, right? So now we need to go back to the my home page. I need to go back to the main page after clicking on this. So for that, what you have to do is you need to use one command called browser dot switch to browser dot switch to of dot default content. So this is a method, default content. So this will again go and switch back to the main page. So after clicking here, I'll just wait for some time. I'll say browser dot sleep, let's wait for 3 seconds of time, then go to the browser. So this is the first action we have done for first frame. So first we switch to the first frame, then clicking on the link on the first frame and waiting for 3 seconds, then we go back to the main page. So now we need to go to the second frame. So how to do this again? We have to use the same command, browser.switch.frame, and we need to capture the name of the second frame. Now inspect these elements, inspect the page, and if you see that this is my next frame, right? So we need to go to the, I think this one is a third frame. I think the first frame is here, second frame is here. So it is when I put my cursor, it is clearly highlighting the frame. And here package frame. So this is my name of the second frame. I can directly pack it, directly specify here. This is my name of the package, name of the frame, package frame. Now this will switch to second frame. So this command will switch to the second frame. Okay, this command switches to the second frame. After that, now we need to again perform the click action on the element in the second frame. So for that again, we use the same command. So we have done the same thing above, same thing. Element by dot link text. Now we need to capture the link text of the element which is present in the second frame. So after clicking on this first link in the second frame, so I want to click on something called Webdriver. So inspect this element and go to the crow path. Then it will show you all the locators. We can use one of them. You can also use class name, or you can use relative XPath or whatever. So link text, tag name is there, and it should also display the link text. We need to properly locate this. Okay, so tag name is available. I think link text also we can use. Let me see whether it is populating link text or not. So this is a web driver, right? So I'll say web driver. I think this one. No, so we need to capture properly. Click on inspect this web driver. Yeah, this is the one, web driver. So for this web driver, so let us see what are the attributes it is giving. So web driver, this is my web driver. Class name is there. And CSS selector, address XPath, tag name, some other locators also there. Okay, I can use link text also because this is basically a link. And all you can put here, it will show you link text. Let's see here. I think it is not displayed. Okay, still we can use link text here. So what I can do is I'm just capturing the web driver. And here, instead of this, I'll say web driver dot click. So this will perform the action on the second frame. So after that, again, I'll wait for 3 more seconds here, and then I'll switch back to the main page. Same copy content, the same content is copied here. So it will go back to the main page. So now we need to go to the third frame. So here we have a third frame again. So in the third frame, after clicking on web driver, there are some tabs are displayed. So here I want to click on index page. Click on the index. So when I inspect this index and go to the crow path, and what it is saying is it is giving relative XPath, CSS, link text, all these things. So let me just capture this XPath, and I'm using this XPath here. So now, but before that, we need to go to the switch to third frame, right? So that's the first activity we need to do. So for that, what you have to do is we need to find the name of the third frame. So this is my class frame. So yeah, this is the one. If I highlight this one frame, it is highlighting the third frame, right? So I can use this class name, copy this, and the same command you have to specify, and name is class frame. So we can specify the class frame, and this will switch to a third frame. Okay. So this will switch to the third frame. Okay, so see it's missing. Yeah, so it will switch to the third frame. So after switching to the third frame, now we need to click on index option. So for the index, we have a locator is available. So after, yeah, for index, it is also giving one XPath. Let's capture this XPath. And now I'm using here. So I'll say element of by dot XPath, and inside this XPath we need to specify that XPath whatever you captured dot click. So this will go and click on index button. So index links. After that, we can just wait for some time just to see the page, or else you can, if you want to put some validation point, you can also put some validation point on this page. All right, so this is how we need to switch to frame. So first what I have to do is we need to switch to the main frame, first frame, and do the action on this frame, and then we need to go back to the main browser. Again, switch to the second frame and perform the action, then go back to the main page. Again, switch to the third frame, perform the action, and go back to the main page. So here, you have multiple frames like this. There's a frame 1, 2, and 3, so we need to do like this. But sometimes you have a nested frames like this. So this is my frame. Inside this, there is one more frame. So in that case, first we need to switch to outer frame. Then we need to switch to inner frame and perform the action. So here we no need to go back to the main page, not required, because this is a nested frame. And we can locate these frames in, we can specify or we can locate the frames in three different ways. So one is here, suppose name is directly available for the frame. So just like this, we can directly pass the name. Or if the name is not available, some ID or some other attributes are available, we have to locate, we need to find that frame to locate the frame and then specify the element here. And the third way is we can also pass the index. Sometimes we have only one or two frames and index will start from zero. When I say index number 0 or 1, it will go and switch to the frame according to the index. But we cannot see index anywhere, so that is just our assumption. So if you have only a single frame, obviously the index of the frame will be 0. So these are the many ways we can switch to the frame and then we can perform the actions. All right, so now we'll see in the last sleep, I'll put 5 so that we can see whether it is properly displayed index page or not. So after creation of everything, and then let us try to execute this. So go to terminal, open the new terminal. And before running this tip, running the script, first we need to make sure frames.js is configured in con.js. Just go to con.js and here I'll say frames.js. So you already configured this frames.js. So now we can directly run your test. So in the terminal, clear, and I'll say protractor space conf folder. Inside this, we have a file called conf.js. So this particular command will run your test. So it will go and navigate to each and every frame and it will perform the action. Now let us execute. So now it is started. So it is launching my browser. Then it will maximize my page, maximize this page. So the last page we can see is index page. Finally, index should display. Okay, so let's see here. Yes. Now it go and click on the second. Yes. Now we can see this is index we can see in the third page, the third frame. So that means my test is successfully done and it is completed. There is no one spec and there are no issues. Right. So this is how we can switch to one frame to another frame to perform the actions within the frame. And until unless we switch to the frame, we cannot perform any actions on the web page or inside the frame. Okay. So it is almost similar to the Selenium Webdriver. In the Selenium Webdriver also, we have the same methods. And instead of browser, there we use Webdriver object. So commands are almost same. So in the similar way, we can also handle frames in the protractor. Okay. So that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.